Hello everybody! So in this video I will show to you some really interesting device. So this device is some sort of solid state C engine and works without any moving parts. In basic everything is solid state. So this device works on magnetohydrodynamics, and in other words, this device is some magnetohydrodynamic drive. So this magnetohydrodynamic drive I have here, and actually is really easy to make. Here in the middle you have some strong magnet. In my case I use some neodymium magnet, and on each side I have connected some aluminium electrodes. So the magnet is isolated because you don't want that these two aluminium electrodes will be shorted. And because the aluminium is not magnetic, I use some screws that the magnet hold the aluminium electrodes together. And that's it, basic. Really simple device. So in basic, this device is not really efficient because you need to put a lot of power that this one will work, and also you will create some hydrogen and some chlorine gas, because in my case I use some water with sodium chloride. Now I put this magnetohydrodynamic drive in my salt water, and I will connect this device to my power supply. So one plate, I mean one electrode, will be the positive. And another will be the negative. Okay, and now I will start my power supply. And now you see this water flow, which is in this direction. But if you change the polarity of the electrodes, then we'll go in opposite direction. Now I will change. And the water flow is in this direction. Really interesting. But like I said, this one is not really efficient because you create a lot of hydrogen, because in this water is also some table salt. You will also get some chlorine gas. So not really efficient device, but looks really interesting. Instead of using aluminium plates, you can also use some copper or some nickel, or like I do, I use some aluminium electrodes. So to make this magnetohydrodynamic drive a little bit more efficient, you need to reduce this distance, because closer are these two electrodes, more water flow you will create. And also if you use much stronger magnet, also you will improve the flow rate of the water. Okay, now I use a little bit stronger magnet. This one is 33 kilograms, and this one is 25 kilograms of pulling power, and also I reduce the distance a little bit. And now you will see a little bit of improvement. So actually this magneto hydrodynamic drive can be also used in some reverse mode and can be used like generator. In this case you need to create some salty water flow between these two electrodes and you will generate a little bit of current. Not too much, but a little bit. Okay. So guys, really interesting magneto hydrodynamic drive. It's really, really awesome because to make one of these don't requires any fancy materials or something like this. So it's really, really easy made. Like I said, between is some isolated magnet. Stronger is the magnet, better will be the water flow. And on each side I have some aluminium, but in your case you can use any metal. For the finish I will replace this aluminium electrodes with some graphite plates. And yeah, also the power which use this device is of course some 5 amps and 12 volts. So not really good, but it's really interesting to play with. Okay, now I have this magneto hydrodynamic drive with some graphite plates. So guys, that's it for now and we see us in the next video. Bye.